Hi friends, good evening. Welcome everyone for today's session on issue of shares against import of capital goods, FEMA perspective. So we will not be covering the Companies Act or any other statute, but specifically from FEMA, what is the regulation? What are the conditions which needs to be followed? What are the documents which are required? And few practical case studies, friends. So before starting, I'd like to acknowledge the effort of Subhash for preparing the presentation. CCPS, the legend CCPS refers to compulsory convertible preference share. Form DI refers to form downstream investment. DPIIT, Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade. ECB, external commercial borrowing. FDI, Foreign Direct Investment. FEMA, Foreign Exchange Management Act 2000. PROI, Person Resident Outside India. The schema for the evening, the introduction, the relevant rules for issue against imports, conditions for issue, timing and reporting of issue, and the few of the case studies. Regulations and reporting requirement. Import of goods means bringing goods into India from a place outside India. Consideration of import can be in the form of cash or kind, maybe shares or goods or etc. When goods are imported, regulations issued under FEMA are to be taken into consideration. Again, as it is said, friends, against that import of capital goods, consideration can be paid in the form of cash or even shares can be issued. What are the various regulations for that? Relevant rules for issue. Automatic route, and so we have to consider two type of approvals here, or two type of routes rather, automatic route and government route, which will be helpful. So the sector in which for which the capital goods are being taken, whether that falls under the automatic route for the purpose of foreign direct investment, or it falls under the government route, that is prior government approval is required. So these two becomes paramount, because basis this the further regulations or the further approvals for issue of shares would be dependent. So let us now see in detail what exactly are the conditions for issue. Conditions for issue of equity instruments against import of capital goods. So I don't know why exactly there has been no. Okay, friends, slides for conditions that includes various conditions, like there are supporting documents in terms of import documents whenever the capital goods are being imported, the relevant documents for that, number one, and specifically where government approval is required. As I said, if the sector in which the capital goods are being taken, where government approval is mandatory, then again for issue of shares as well against import of capital goods, government approval would be required. Timing and reporting of issue. The equity instruments have to be issued within 180 days from the date of shipment of capital goods, machinery or equipment as the case may be. The reporting shall be made in form FCGPR along with relevant attachment within 30 days from the date of issue. So within 180 days of shipment, the issue has to be made. Form FCGPR along with relevant attachments, we have seen in our earlier session, that needs to be filed within 30 days. Practical case studies, friends. Case study one, breach of sectoral cap. So ABC Private Limited is a telecom infrastructure provider in India. NAC Limited in UK has invested in the CCPS of ABC Private Limited in such a manner that it holds 49% in ABC Private on a fully diluted basis. So up to 49% in telecom service sector, it is automatic route. Beyond 49%, it is approval route. So up to 49% FDI can be allowed under automatic. After that, the government approval would be required. ABC Private Limited imported capital goods from NAC Limited worth USD 10 billion. So there was a transaction of purchase of capital goods from NAC Limited worth 10 million, against which the Indian company decided not to pay the amount in cash, but in the form of issue of shares. But by this issue, there would be an additional stake of 10% of NAC Limited in ABC. So that will be 59%. So now when it is 59% for this issue as well, government approval would be required. So when there is the investment exceeds the sectoral cap, in such a scenario, government approval would be required at the time of issue. Case study two, company A Private Limited in India is engaged in mining activity, is a subsidiary of B Inc. USA. Again, it's a subsidiary, it's not a wholly owned subsidiary, friends. A imported capital goods from Zambia for which the consideration was paid by B Limited. So again, the capital goods were imported from a third party Zambian company for which the consideration, there was some management consideration was paid by B. Now, whatever consideration is being paid by B, that would be regarded as deemed external commercial borrowings as per regulations relating to ECB. Now, against this loan or borrowing, B has agreed to convert the same into equity on A's request. So, A needs to know the following, whether the conversion would be regarded as foreign investment, number one. Second, compliance requirements arising from this arrangement under FEMA. So, yes, when there is a conversion of ECB into equity, it would be regarded or it would be reckoned as foreign investment, that is, or it would get count in total foreign investment, since the conversion is for the purpose of B's equity holding in A, FEMA provisions would be applicable. Now, what are the various other ramifications in terms of the poor Jarvis Kassel? In many activities, 100% D is allowed. Hence, still, so the early the stake were less than 100%, it was not on wholly owned subsidiary. But because of this, there may be chances the shareholding of UK company would increase Indian company. Nevertheless, 100% FDI is allowed in mining sector under automatic route, so no need of any government approval. But if sector had cap less than 100%, say 14%, and after conversion the shareholding exceeds 49%. Then in such a scenario, approval from government have been required. So please be clear, friends. Here the sector was such that 100% FDI is allowed. That's the reason no government approval be required for this issue of shares for converting ECB into equity share. But had the sector been where 49% is allowed under automatic route and above government approval is required, and because of this conversion the shareholding exceeds 49%, then this issue also would have required government approval. A has to obtain approval from RBI in case of ECB. So government approval would not be required for this issue of shares, but approval from RBI via AD Bank would be required, and he needs to file all the relevant forms, comply with applicable pricing guidelines, form FCGPR would be relevant. Now, the third scenario is again relating to a downstream investment, friends. There are two companies, both are into pharmaceutical sector, and there's a foreign company C, which has 74% equity holding in company B and 51% stake in company A. The maximum limit which is allowed under this sector is 74%, where company A and B operates. A is in need of some machinery which is required for sorting its goods in warehouse. For this purpose, it imported machinery worth ₹100 million from company D in UK. So company C is holding 74% in company B, 51% in company A. A is purchasing some machinery from company D. The consideration for such import was paid by B. So company B, there was some arrangement, we are not getting into that arrangement, but that consideration for basis that arrangement, the consideration was paid by company B, which is again an Indian company. After the consideration was paid, A for the purpose of settling this amount, he requested again the issue of equity instruments against this. So with that, B would be holding 30%. So against that consideration, whatever settlement had to happen, it would happen in equity instruments, and by issue of that equity instruments, B stake in A would be 30%. So friends, please be clear, 51% is of company C in company A. With this issue, company B also would have 30% stake in A. Just to note, company C already holds 74% in company B. Now, this is a case of downstream investment. Whether in such a scenario, government approval would be required or not, let us find first. Even though shares are issued only to a resident, the concept of indirect foreign investment has to be considered. The company which has received indirect foreign investment shall also comply with entry route, sectoral cap, pricing guidelines, and other conditions. So indirect foreign investment means downstream investment received by an Indian entity from another Indian entity which has received foreign investment, which is the case in this example. And the A is, that is the Indian entity, is not owned and not controlled by resident Indian citizens. We are assuming for time being second condition is fulfilled. So thus, this would be considered as indirect foreign investment. So now what would be the ramifications? So this is a diagram as we have seen. If the settlement is made through equity shares of company A, total foreign investment, that is direct plus indirect, in company A would be 81%. So 51% of C, which is direct, 30% of B. Why to reckon 30% and aggregate it to 81%? Because B has foreign investment in it of company C. So now, whether again 74% of 30% to be considered or entire 30%, that is again a clarity is required. For a safer side, it is better to consider 30% fully. So 30 plus 51% comes to 81%, which is more than the sectoral cap of 74%. Thus, in such a scenario, government approval would be required. However, here again, all the compliances relating to getting government approval has to be done by B. B has to obtain a certificate from statutory auditor on annual basis. Again, shall bring in the requisite funds from abroad, which is not the case. Board resolution also needs to be passed for receiving the downstream investment. So all the compliances relating to government approval has to be performed by B. Now, very important note, which also includes the compliances also includes B shall file form DA, that is form direct investment firms portal within 30 days of the date of allotment of equity instruments. Very important, filing of FCGPR would not be applicable. Friends, still this would be considered as foreign investment, but there won't be any filing of FCGPR because there is no issue of shares to a resident outside India. Company A is issuing shares to company B. Thus, in such a scenario, from FCGPR filing would not be required, but this all other filings as we have seen, that is getting certificate from statutory auditor, filing to be done on annual basis, filing of form with on the firm's portal, everything needs to be done, and that needs to be done by company B and not company A. So these were a few case studies and some of our thoughts on this practical aspect of what happens when issue of shares are being contemplated against import of capital goods. We thought to make it more interesting with few case studies and to give you a practical perspective as to how generally this works. Any questions would be happy to answer, friends.